My name is Dr. James Black, and I'm a vascular surgeon and endovascular surgeon here at Johns Hopkins Hospital, and I regularly perform aortic operations on patients of all ages and all distributions along the aortic tree. So abdominal aortic aneurysm is a weakness of the abdominal aorta. It tends to produce a dilation of the blood vessel, whereas normally it's about the size of a garden hose. It can grow to reach up to 5, 6, or 7 centimeters, close to the size of a liter bottle of soda. It's also the 15th leading cause of death in the United States for among adults. There are three ways that physicians treat abdominal aortic aneurysms. The first is surveillance, which of course is the easiest of all ways we treat aneurysms. Not every aortic aneurysm needs to be treated. A lot can be safely monitored as long as the patient is under surveillance, which can be sometimes performed with something as simple as an ultrasound over a CAT scan or an MRI. The second way we treat aneurysms is with open surgery, which has traditionally been done for the last 50 or 60 years. Very good outcomes, with expectedly a longer recovery because of the nature of the incisions and the body cavity and working around the whole aorta. More recently, in the last 10 or 15 years, we've been treating abdominal aortic aneurysms with stents, which has the advantage of a more minimally invasive approach and avoidance of the major incisions that plagued the recovery of patients who underwent the open surgery. A fenestrated stent graft is a new device that builds upon a very time-tested and excellent platform that we've been using in the United States for over 15 years. The prior version of a stent graft was predominantly used just below the kidney arteries themselves, and in fact covered probably 50 to 60% of all abdominal aortic aneurysms that we treat. A fenestrated stent graft implies that the stent graft itself has small windows cut into it so that now we can bring the stent graft up across the kidney blood vessels themselves, thereby capturing another 20 or 30% of patients and now making them a candidate for an endovascular aneurysm repair, whereas previously they would have had to undergo an open surgery with a much longer recovery. The benefits of a fenestrated stent graft really build upon the success that we've had over the last 10 or 15 years with a traditional endovascular aneurysm repair. That is, we have smaller incisions, faster recovery, and generally a much shorter hospital stay. Most patients will be in the hospital only 2 or 3 days. The specific advantage of the fenestrated stent graft over what we've been doing is that it allows now us to treat aneurysms that go close to the kidney arteries themselves. And by doing this type of procedure, we can keep the circulation going to those kidneys as we're actually placing the stent, whereas with a traditional open surgery, we would have had to interrupt the circulation to the kidneys for anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes, which with a much higher risk for kidney failure after the operation. Patients who are eligible for a fenestrated aortic stent graft are those whose aneurysms are close to the kidney arteries themselves, and also have the time to wait for the device to be engineered. All of these devices are actually built for the patient individually. That is, once a device is made, it can't really be used for anyone else in the entire world. So by doing a CAT scan before the procedure, we measure up the stent graft specific to the patient's anatomy, and then order it from a company, which takes around 4 to 6 weeks for the device to finally be delivered. The main risks of a fenestrated aortic endovascular repair is that of an endoleak. That is, after we place the device, that we still see leakage around the aortic endovascular device into the aneurysm sac itself. This is where the premium is really put upon understanding the anatomy of the patient individually. So if we're able to get a very good result in terms of the fit of this stent against the patient, those risks are much less. Other risks that can occur with a fenestrated aortic endovascular repair are mostly referred to those of the kidney. Sometimes some of the stents that we put in the kidney arteries themselves can have trouble lining up correctly and produce kinks and narrow the blood flow into the kidneys themselves. At the time of the procedure, we take multiple views of those stents into the kidney arteries to make sure that the circulation to each kidney is not adversely affected during the procedure. The recovery from a fenestrated aortic endovascular repair versus a traditional aortic endovascular repair is not much different. That is, the patient would come in on the day of surgery and probably go home 2 or maybe 3 days later. In fact, some of our aortic endovascular procedures we can do percutaneously and even have the patient go home the next day. In comparison to an open procedure, it's much like apples and oranges. An open procedure is a much longer recovery in the hospital, usually one or two nights in the ICU, and feeling not like oneself for about a month after the surgery. Final recovery from an open operation could take up to 4 to 6 weeks. After a patient undergoes a fenestrated aortic endovascular aneurysm repair, they can expect to come back to the hospital or to the outpatient clinic for a follow-up appointment approximately 4 to 6 weeks after surgery. That first appointment is very important. At that appointment, we would do a CAT scan to make sure that the aortic endovascular repair is functioning well and there's no sign of any leakage or effects upon the kidneys. The next appointment would probably not be for a year. And at that point, we would probably still do another CAT scan, or for those patients whose kidney function goes into the procedure is somewhat marginal, we might switch to an ultrasound to make sure that the aortic endovascular repair is functioning well and that there's no evidence of leakage into the aneurysm sac, and that also the aneurysm sac begins to shrink down, which we usually take as the best sign of durability of the repair overall. Johns Hopkins has been at the head of aortic surgery for close to 100 years. Many of the aortic operations that occur around the country, even around the world, have their birth in the hands of surgeons who trained at Hopkins at some point along the way. In terms of the fenestrated aortic endovascular repair, Johns Hopkins is one of 30 centers around the country that has access to the technology to deliver such a device. The team we have at Hopkins is very good at what they do. Many people here have great interest in the patients and put the patient at the forefront of the decision making. Many aneurysms will not need to be treated, but when they do need to be treated, the team we have here is going to be one of the best.